help!
From rescuing kittens to battling blazes, firefighters are the backbone of our neighborhoods. Join me for an ordinary day in the extraordinary lives of these brave men and women and their groundbreaking machines. This is Mighty Jobs, powered by Volvo Penta. Okay, I'll give you one guess where we are this time. It's a vibrant coastal city in my beautiful home country, on the shores of the Pacific Ocean, in the traditional and unceded territories of the Musqueam, Tsleil-Waututh, and Squamish nations. It's known for its stunning natural beauty and diverse culture, and has been the filming location for numerous Hollywood blockbusters. We are, of course, in Vancouver, Canada. We're here at Vancouver Fire Rescue Services, who recently received an electrifying new addition to their fleet. But this won't do. This is better. I've been promised a ride along for the day with the outstanding firefighters at Fire Hall Number 1.
Here, Lacey, this is for you. Let's go.
Firefighters always need to be ready, and in true fashion, I barely had time to catch my breath before our call came in. Say hello to the Rosenbauer RTX, Canada's first electric fire truck. It's powered by a Volvo Penta electric driveline, specifically engineered to meet the rigorous demands of modern firefighting. It offers several enhancements over traditional fire trucks, such as ergonomics, maneuverability, noise reduction, and health benefits. In 2023, Vancouver Fire Rescue Services had more than 72,000 calls, 4,309 reported fires, and an average response time of 6 minutes and 46 seconds. This truck in particular handles about 13 calls a day, all on battery power. The water tank on the RTX holds up to 2,800 liters, and the electrically powered fire pump can spray water from the roof turret up to 75 meters.
So a call came in at the hall, and before I could even get my safety vest on here, everyone was suited up. Before I knew it, they're already in assessing the scene, so it's really amazing to see how effective these guys are at their job.
One thing you'll notice, Lacey, is this truck is really loud behind us, but the RTX sitting over there is making almost no sound right now.
Yeah.
So on a scene that's chaotic like this and busy,
that makes a difference.
It makes a huge difference.
This is even the loudest you'll probably get it because our pump's running right now.
Okay.
And I'm still not having to yell at you.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah.
I couldn't hear you over there.
Another bonus.
Before I knew it, the situation was already wrapping up. A fairly standard call, according to these guys. Fire on the top floor and a resident with smoke inhalation. But the fire was contained, put out, and the resident got taken care of. And just like that, we were back on the road.
What do you love the most about your job?
I would say my coworkers. It's a cool job, like no day is ever the same. You're always getting out, you're on your feet, you're working with tools, you're communicating with members of the public. But overall, the best thing for me is just being at the fire hall with like pretty much like some of my best friends.
It's great because you learn a bunch of skills that can be used in a lot of areas of life outside of even teamwork, is just like the medical stuff, and then best case scenario, you're making a difference in people's lives for the positive. You see them on their worst days and you can make them a little bit better. It's great.
So what did you guys think when you heard you were gonna get an electric fire truck?
It's a very new technology for us. We've been, you know, running diesel trucks forever, so
I was a little concerned about the battery life and how long it was gonna be, but it does have a diesel backup generator to charge the battery, so there's really no concern about battery life. If we're stuck at a fire for a long time, that generator's gonna kick in.
I like it a lot more. It drives way nicer than the other trucks. It being a little bit smaller makes it a lot easier because we do have a lot of tight spots to get into, so suspension's better, turning radius is better, and you can spin around like full U-turn in the middle of the street, no problem. It also has four different ride heights.
Oh, wow.
It's really easy to get in and out with all our gear. And if we need to pop it way up for going off-road, we have that option.
Ergonomically, it's laid out perfectly. There's lots of room. A big screen up here. You can easily see a lot of the information. And of course, cameras, our radio system, siren, and all that.
Wow.
A lot of people have been calling the guys that drive this the battery boys. I don't know if it's going to stick or not.
Battery boys!
So I'm sure designing all the technology behind this was no easy feat. But what do you have to say, Mia?
I mean, where to start?
Actually, this is where it all begins. The life of an electric driveline starts here, right here in our workshop. Since 2012, we have developed electric drivelines for different applications based on proven Volvo Group technology. This technology has been running in electric buses, trucks, and construction machinery.
Our exploration with off-highway electrification started with terminal tractors. A success factor has been the close collaboration with customers and operators. Fit for purpose, an electric driveline in harmony with the application and happy operators have been our guiding stars. As the adoption of electrical applications and the need for electricity accelerates, the demand for charging and grid support increases. That's why we have taken the same battery pack in our drivelines and adapted that into a subsystem for our BESS manufacturers. A BESS can help to address grid limitations. Its uses include helping with peak shavings, fast charging for electric applications, backup power, and many more. It's essentially a large power bank that can store and discharge electricity quickly when needed, like charging an electric fire truck. Speaking of, let's check back in with Lacey.
All right, Lacey, you've seen how we work. Now we're going to put you to work.
All right, I'm ready.
We're going to go take care of that.
That's a real fire.
Kind of.
What do you mean?
That's our training facility, and it's your time to shine. Let's get to it.
Water coming on!
Okay, Lacey, we're gonna grab this nozzle right here and we're gonna head down in this direction, okay?
Okay.
Head down that way. We're going in that window right over there.
Okay.
Ready for water on line two?
What? Is this line two?
Here comes water, Lacey. Go ahead. Okay, shut it down a little bit, but take it out of the window. So these guys are gonna go in and make entry right now. Put the fire out. Okay, go in. Everyone in, and you can shut that one down, okay? Fire! Once we've got a crew interior, we shut this line down so that we're not spraying water onto the crews that are inside the building. So they go in and push the fire from inside to outside. Fire's out.
Way to go, guys. That was
great
awesome.
Job, nice
you guys are the best. We did it.
I had a lot of fun, and it was awesome to get a glimpse into the ordinary day in your extraordinary lives.
Not a problem. You did fantastic out there.
Up top.
Nice work.
All right. Well, I guess if you don't need me anymore, I'm going to head back to the hotel, have a nap, grab some snacks.
Not necessary. We've got snacks and beds at the fire hall. Come with me.
Okay.
Well, we got another call coming in. Let's go, Lacey.